Being a chemistry professor means that I have the freedom to explore my intellectual pursuits.
To be a professor means that I get to be creative.
To me, being a professor is really about education and problem solving.
I love being a professor. If you ask, what is we really do? Well, we create things, and this involves many, many people.
There are a lot of responsibilities for chemistry professors. The obvious ones are teaching, doing research, and service, meaning you might be on different committees at the university, in your department, or even in the bigger community. Beyond that, though, professors are constantly writing research publications. They're reviewing those publications for other people through the peer review process. They're writing grants, reviewing grants. They might be doing community service. There really are endless number of things that start coming your way that you may not have been expecting.
Teaching is an incredibly important part of the job, but it's only one part of the job. I think that's the biggest myth. We actually do a lot of research, really cutting-edge research.
Basically, when you start a job like this, you're given lab space and you are given financial resources to go out and recruit students, and then it's really up to you to choose the projects and work with graduate students on making those projects successful.
My research involves making new material. One of the things we've worked on is graphene. It's a new form of carbon, and we're particularly interested in its energy storage properties. So we've made these devices called supercapacitors. They look like batteries, they have two electrodes and electrolyte, but they can be discharged and charged much faster. So someday you'll be able to charge your cell phone in under 30 seconds.
One of my main projects that I'm working on now is polymers or plastics to stabilize medicines both inside and outside of the body.
A chemistry professor, and I think a university professor in general, have a responsibility to reach out to the community. And community outreach is essential to bring diversity to the university and to the economic enterprise of the country.
Mentoring is a critical part of our job because really what we're doing is we're working with students, we're preparing the students to learn how to do research and ultimately for the workforce.
The process of grant writing is one of the most exciting and rewarding parts of one's job.
In order to sustain our research, we have to write grants. But it also allows me to determine what course of action I need to do to test the hypothesis. It's a blueprint for what I'm going to do in my research for the next 3 to 5 years.
I think a common misconception about faculty is that the salaries are really low, but you can see from a lot of faculty that they're able to get paid well by the university. Many faculty will even start companies. Some faculty will consult at different companies. So there are other opportunities to make money and do well financially.
To become a professor in chemistry, you need an undergraduate degree, a PhD typically in chemistry, and do a postdoc for at least 1 or 2 years in a field that's similar or distinct from what you did as a PhD.
The process is structured, but it doesn't have to be linear. In my own experience, I knew I wanted to go to grad school and I needed to support myself. So to be able to do that, I got a job as a truck driver. I continued to volunteer in the lab, so I never stopped doing research. Truck driving paid the bills, and in the afternoon, I was getting more experience as a chemist.
You're often working very hard your first half dozen years because you want to achieve the best you can do. And assuming you've done well, and most people these days, given enough resources and enough help from talented undergraduates and graduate students, do well, and then you achieve tenure.
The perks of being a chemistry professor are really endless. The students are very inspiring, they're very curious, they ask difficult questions, they solve very difficult problems, and that's probably the most fun part is they'll take it in directions that you never foresaw.
Every day is different. There's always something new, something challenging.
You have a great number of resources at your disposal. You have access to very top people in business and law, as well as engineering, medicine, biology, and physics. I can't think of any other place where people are so willing to help you on projects and collaborate.
The truth of the matter is that there is a tremendous need for chemistry professors in the country at all levels of education, at research universities, comprehensive universities, community colleges, liberal arts colleges. So there is a tremendous need for people who are passionate about teaching chemistry.
Do you have what it takes?
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 Do you have what it takes?